abantu bangi bagwao ne bagenda okujja kaabo abaleke ebintu bifanagana nga bwe biti era sebo kiri wa president ntwala kakisa kano okwebaza mu buntu ate n'okwebaza nga government kubanga mulaze obwesimbu n'obwenkanya eri abakolera eggwanga emirimu emirungi kyalibadde kyakulyaza amaanya ku mirimu gya Badru Kakungulu n'atafuna kitiibwa kino ekimuweerebbwa mu ggwanga lino.
That was Dr. Sheikh Ahmad Kisule for you, a great preacher and a career diplomat. After his speech, the master of ceremonies, Alhaji Dr. Achegbuhu, invited President Museveni to speak, and the president made very remarkable revelations. Wanapedia invites you to the president's speech and thereafter for the laying to rest of Prince Badru Kakungulu.
It's a pleasure and honor to invite His Excellency the President to address you.
Abarangira na nabambeja.
Princes and princesses.
And the widow and the children. On behalf of the government of Uganda, I would like to tell all of you and those who are not here that we deeply mourn the late Prince Badru Kakungulu. This, first of all, as a human being, he has departed, as the Sheikh was preaching. But additionally, Prince Kakungulu was not an ordinary Ugandan or an ordinary Muslim. I came to know him in 1980, when I came back from Tanzania,
1979.
Prior to that, before I went into exile in the 60s, I used to hear of him, but I did not know him personally.
But
when I came to know him personally, and the reason why I said that he was not an ordinary Ugandan, I found him to be, first of all, a very wise man. The Banyankore have got to say that NC etene mkuru ejendwa wira, meaning that a nation which does not have wise old men, you cannot get hospitality anywhere. When you are traveling, if you knock on this door, they will not open for you because there is nobody to welcome you.
Abanyankole bali n'enjogere egamba nti ensi etabaamu bantu bakulu ebanga teriimu na bikolwa bya kisa kubanga bw'obanga otambula n'okonfona ku luggi tewabaawo ajja kukuggulirawo.
This saying Abanyankole came to after one king in that area in the olden days demanded a beautiful skin of a zebra. He saw a zebra. You know, a zebra has got a beautiful skin. He ordered his people, he said, you go and kill that zebra, remove the skin, and I want to wear it. A zebra.
Yalaba entulege, neyegomba okwambala eddiba lyayo, Nara jira abantu bantu bantu banagata abantu bange mugende muyige tulegeyo mugibage ke diba muri ndetere ndiyambare.
They went and killed the zebra. They brought the hide of the zebra. Then he said, "You saw the hide on me because I want to look as beautiful as that zebra."
Kati bamuletera ediba nga babazo okutta entulege ne balete diba yaleto salaga manti kakati ne diba lino mulintu ngeko kubana enjagala mberere dala mulunji nga entulege li mulintu sikulyambala naye mulintu ngeko nfuke entulege mu bulunji bwange.
Ndabike ngentulege.
Ndabike ngentulege. Thank you very much.
this same king was a bad king. He was a harsh king. So previously, he had ordered that all old people should be killed. And all old people were killed according to his order. Then came the story of the zebra. Now, they put the skin on him, they sewed it, and then, as you know, the skin, as it begins to dry, it becomes very tight. So it started squeezing him when it started drying.
Nilitandika okumunyiga kubanga ya yemima nilitandika okumunyiga nokumumima.
And the man was in a very bad shape.
Na obulumi awo natandika okukawulira.
Then he said in Runyankore, he says, tene mkuru. Ensei no, tena mkuru. Who can, does this nation have a wise old man who can help me with this problem of the skin?
Yeah. Kati no awulira obulumi kyavaga ate abakulu yabatadda mu nsi muno temukyalimu mukulu yenna ayinza okunyamba ku buzibu buno bwentuuseemu obw'eddiba lino erinnyiga.
Then there was one wise man whom they had hidden.
Bajjanga omusajja mwani musigaddemu omusajja omu omuzeeyo w'amagezi gwe baali bakwese.
Then when they saw the man was in a real predicament, they brought this old man.
So
the old man put him in the water, and when the skin was soft, he cut it. Because otherwise it would have gone with his skin if he had cut it with
him.
So from that day, the Banyankore started the saying that Nsetene Mukuru Ejendwa Wira, the nation which has no elderly wise man, you don't get hospitality anywhere. That's how the Banyankore started it.
Kaino kokwavu rugero rwa Banyankore runenjogera yabwe nti ensi egwamu abakuru ebanga teki alimu bikora byakisa.
So Prince Badru was a wise man.
Kaino mulangira kakunguru yali musajja wa magezi.
This is what I noticed in him when I started talking to him.
Kino kye nasooka okumwetegerezaamu bwe natandika okwogera naye.
Before I went to the bush, I came and I saw him.
Nga sinaba kugenda mu kisaka, nga sinaba kugenda mu nsiko, nasooka kujja wano ne mmulaba kumwebuuzaako.
This was after the elections.
Najja okumulaba nga okulonda kuli muwanga kwe ya hijackinga kumaze okubaawo.
First he said in Uganda, he says, "Ebintu bigenze bubi." That's what he said in Uganda.
Namula anangati ebintu bigenze bubi. Things are going badly.
Then I told him that things would be all right. We shall sort it out.
Chokanze nemugumya nemugati ebintu bijja kuterera.
Then he said, "How will you sort it out?"
Nangati onobiterezo otya.
I told him that we shall fight and throw a boat out.
Nemugati tujja kulwana obote tumu.
Then he kept quiet, and then he said, "Naye guanga liyefiri nafuka duaniro." That's what he said in Uganda.
Na soko asiri chiri la mucho kabu ya mara moko kuzala kabanga na ganta na yeka kwa kati guanga liyefiri ngabe mulide. Will our country become a battlefield?
Then I explained to him that it was better sometimes to sort it out once and for all.
Choka ne mtegeza nti orusi kiba kitufu kisiga kwa burungi okuluana ebintu ebwebityo ne mubisolvinga ne mubimalira oddala.
Then he said, Kale, he prayed for me in this Islamic way, which I don't understand myself.
Kale, Kale, what you nangamba anti Kale, nanta, nansabide mikisa, nanombele dua, mungede ye kisira, mungesa tegera bulunji.
He didn't know my plans, but I went with his blessing, with his knowledge.
Te yamanya mteka teka zange, chokana genda, nga nginzi ni mikisaji.
So when we came back, in 1986, again I started meeting him.
Nuruki betwa komawo ngarumazo kuangula kwenda kinana mukaga era na komawo ne mulaba.
And as Murangira Mulondo was saying, he was always giving me advice on the issues of Buganda, or the people, the monarchy, people want monarchy and all that. He used to give me a very sound advice, and also to advise the other people who were involved.
Kale ngo mulangira sabalangira mulondo bwagambye bwe namulabanga yampanga amagezi malungi nnyo naddala ku bigambo ebikwata ku Baganda bikwata ku babo abaali baagala okuzzaawo obwakabaka nze nampa amagezi malungi ate n'abo abaali bakuba kerere ku nsonga ezo nabo ng'era nabo abawa amagezi.
So I found him very, very wise and moderate, and he would hesitate and speak slowly, weighing what he said.
Kaya na musanga anga musajja mugezi, musajja mkwata mpora, asiri ikirira, ebintu byayogera amala kubipima, nalyoka ayogera angeyo byayogedde, ngebyo byennyini ebigwanidde wabyogeredde.
He had a sound mind, very sound mind, and very good memory.
Obwongo bwe bwali buyitirivu ate n'okujjukira kwe kwali kwawala nnyo nga talina kintu kyonna kakibe kya myaka ekyaliwo myaka ataano myaka nsanvu myaka biga buli kintu kyonna akijjukira n'akukibuulira ekibanga ekyaliwo jjo.
And once he put on his spectacles he could read anything.
Ate bwe yateekangako galubindi ng'asobola okusoma ekintu kyonna.
English, Uganda, you could read everything. So losing such a man at this time is really a big loss to the country. But we can try to immortalize his memory by studying his principles of life, both in private and in public. As somebody said, he was a reconciliator. He was always reconciling people.
Omungo waliwo bwa omwagambye yali mutabaganya. Ebanga lyonna yali atabaganya abantu.
Once he told me a story how he advised the late Sir Edward Mutesa to cancel one day where the Christians were celebrating the defeat of the Muslims in Kabura. I have forgotten the name of that day.
Rumuya yantegeza ngabwe yawa Sekabaka Mutesa amagezi balekerawo okukuza olunaku lwe bayitanga olunaku olw'emirembe
in Kabura or some place like that. And he says that the late Sir Edward accepted his advice.
Sekabaka Mutesa.
So as to promote reconciliation.
So
we have really lost a great man. And for me, I was quite unlucky because yesterday when he died, I was coming to see him. I was on the way, coming to see him. I remember 1980 when I was vice chairman of the military commission. Chigundu and others, I have forgotten the others, came to see me about these Muslim matters.
Nzejo chila mrukumenda mchinana Wendaringa ze vice chairman wa military commission Dr. Kigundu na barada besi kia jukira Bagi okunda ba kubi nsonga ezi kwata kubi nsonga zaba silamu Zob dini yoku silamu.
Then I told them that I had no knowledge about Muslim matters. I am having enough problems understanding Christian problems, which I belong to. Now, how would I understand the Muslim problem? No, so I told Kigundu, I said this is a matter for the courts. Either the one group is right. No, I asked Kigundu, do you have a constitution? They say yes, we have got a constitution. But if you have got a constitution, then what is the problem? Why don't you go and sort it out in the courts? So I referred them to the special branch. Say you go and talk to the special branch, then they will take you to the courts if you are not satisfied. In fact, I remember I introduced Kigundu to a man called Somugen, who later on became Inspector General of Police. At that time, he was head of a special branch at that time. So interfering of the state into religious matters is not correct. Abasajja tulemeddwa okugula ebirime by'abantu. Enguto zikyali na bizibu. Tetunawo kuzirongosa zona twakalongosa ko ntono za wano mutawuni. N'ebizibu ebirala byonna ate netwongeraku ebintu tuyingira mu byeddiini okwefuula abasheikh ngaona avudde wano. So I think it was right to oppose this interference of state into religious affairs. And Prince Badru was very prominent in that. And he had to go to detention for that. I remember he was also put in detention. So in addition to being a wise man, the prince was a freedom fighter. Therefore, when he died, it was very easy for us to decide to accord him state honors of the highest degree, just like the ones we accorded to our late friend Cardinal Subuga, because of the distinguished service he rendered to the religious community and to the country as a whole.
Norwegio Nzenga Sagara Kutwara Nyori Sera, Sevichatu Kanga Fudde, Tetwasa Anga Zibu, Opusara Wu, Nti Tumuzike Mutikiwa, Olw'emirimu Emirungi, Giyakola, Mudini, Era Giyakola, Nemukwanga, Okutwalira Awamu. Ngawera Tetwasara Wu, Tebitiwa Binyini Vingiri Era, Biwewe, Nemune, Kalidinari, Nsuruga.
The state, the government, will do everything possible to help the widow and the orphans. Thank you very much.
After the president's address, Sheikh Rajab Kakoza led a funeral prayer before the body of the late prince was taken to its final resting place.
Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله برا أتوكيري ناي منا تمبا مبفو لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله
ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير
لقد His Excellency the President Ahuza Hajati Kapunguru Gakati Ahuziza Kasim Kapunguru Ni Nabawanuka Nekalifani Nebadiru Uyo kati president abuza nalinya we wamara
la ilaha illa allah la ilaha illa allah muhammadur rasulullah
la ilaha illa allah.
Welcome back from Chiguli Hill, the home of the Kakungurus, where you have just witnessed the burial of Umulangira Badru Kakunguru. Kasimuna Kibinge is a tough man, but he was certainly overwhelmed by the loss of his father and he had to be escorted away. There are times when we have to admit that crying has very, very high therapeutic values. When you cry, is something you release. When you bottle up, you are likely to explode. I'm not trying to annoy those whose faiths tell them never to cry, but it is very, very human to cry. In this holy month of Ramadan, we again invite the Muslim community to partake of local products. Toke biscuits, Uzima water, products made in Uganda, Ugandan products by Ugandans. Herbert Semiano reminds you very strictly to make sure you subscribe to Wanapedia. Otherwise, you risk missing out on history, without which your future will be behind you. Thank you very much.